Welcome back. Speaker of the House Nancy Pelosi is encouraging Democrats to support health care reform at all costs, even if it means losing their elected seats. But Fox News senior political analyst Britt Hume says that could be dangerous. Listen.
It's distinctly possible she may be able to round up enough votes to pass something. The question then, of course, becomes whether she's leading her troops on a suicide mission, which I think she may well be doing.
Pennsylvania Representative Jason Altmaier joins us now. Congressman, do you feel like you're on a suicide mission?
I think every member has to go back to their district and decide that they're going to cast their vote for the way that their constituents want. I represent a district where there's been some skepticism over the health care bills that have been put forward in the past. I voted against the House health care bill for that reason. I'm not going to cast a vote that my constituents aren't comfortable with.
Let's be honest about something here. After Scott Brown won the election in Massachusetts, were there some conservative Democrats who had originally voted yes for health care reform who said, whew, thank goodness Scott Brown won, even though he's a Republican, because now I don't have to vote for health care reform?
Well, the House already had a vote, so every member of the House is on record one way or the other. I do think there are probably some people who voted yes that went home and they were not well received and would like to have a do-over. I think there might be some folks on the other side of that as well. But there probably are people who voted yes that would like to have a second bite of the apple.
All right, I want to listen to the speaker again because she uses one word in particular about you as Democrats and what you should do when it comes to the health care reform vote. Listen.
Well, first of all, our members, every one of them wants health care. I think everybody wants affordable health care for all Americans. They know that this will take courage. It took courage to pass Social Security. It took courage to pass Medicare. And many of the same forces that were at work decades ago are at work again against this bill.
Is her courage argument convincing enough for you to risk your career and vote yes?
Well, again, risking your career implies that you're going to cast a vote that is blatantly against the will of your constituents. I'm not going to do that. I represent a district that is pretty evenly split politically. I hear from both sides on this issue. The House health care bill, by and large, was unpopular in my district. Mm-hmm. We'll see what the president puts out, and then I'm going to make my decision. But I don't think any member, very few, are going to cast votes that are absolutely on the other side of public opinion in their districts.
Well, Congressman, let me ask you this. The president now apparently going to unveil a new plan tomorrow. Mm-hmm. The word on the street is that he actually listened to the Republicans last week and that he may incorporate things that they like tort reform and portability, being able to cross over state lines with your insurance plan. Would that kind of change convince you to vote yes?
I need to see that this bill that's being put forward is substantially different than the bill I had to vote on in the House. I voted no for some very specific reasons, a lack of cost containment. I didn't like the income tax increase that was in there,
right.
And I didn't like the mandate on small businesses.
Right. So if it those still costs issues, $1 trillion, if it still costs $1 trillion, but it does incorporate Republican ideas, you would still vote no?
Again, I need to see the bill. If they put the same package and the same framework in front of me I voted on in the House, my vote's going to be the same. But if there's substantial changes and it brings down the cost of health care, I'd consider it. But I need to see the bill first.
All right. Well, we're all going to hear what the president has to say about the changes tomorrow. Congressman Jason Altmaier, Democrat from Pennsylvania, thank you for being our guest this morning.
Thanks.